Welcome to Jung Tuition. I am Jung. Let's continue discussing basic issues in weather and climate research. Today, I'm going to compare different models for Earth with its atmosphere. Are you ready? Let's go and have fun. In modern astrophysics, the simplest model for a remote star or planet is a blackbody, which allows estimation of the surface temperature by using the Stefan-Boltzmann law. Seen from the remote space through an infrared telescope, Earth looks like a ball emitting rays in all directions, with average intensity close to 239 watt per meter square. Treating Earth as a black body, the emission temperature is just 255 Kelvin, which is much lower than the global mean surface temperature today. It's okay, because after all, it's just an estimation. Notice the 255 Kelvin happens to be the atmospherical temperature around 5 kilometers above the surface. That's why the term emission height or emission altitude has been introduced. However, this is a misconception. The emission temperature 255 Kelvin has nothing to do with any atmospherical temperature, simply because a black body is a structureless object that has no atmosphere. Still, many attempts have been made to treat the condensed matter part of Earth as a black body with its surface temperature 288 Kelvin. This implies that the infrared intensity is over 150 watt per meter square, higher than the observed planetary radiance, 239 watt per meter square. Obviously, such an isolated black body is unstable and would cool down by 33 Kelvin eventually, and it becomes 255 Kelvin. But the story didn't end there. In 1860, Tyndall first observed a good infrared absorber is also a good infrared emitter. Those infrared absorbers he measured include water vapor and carbon dioxide. In 1896, Arrhenius proposed the first climate model, in which the condensed matter part of Earth was still treated as a black body. In addition, the atmosphere was simplified as a single layer made by water vapor and CO2 hanging over the surface. In this way, Arrhenius first estimated the global cooling and the global warming associated with the change in the CO2 concentration in the atmosphere. For over a century, based on Arrhenius' two-layer model, the greenhouse effect was calculated as a difference between the two radiances. One is the black body at temperature 288 Kelvin, and another is a black body at temperature 255 Kelvin, namely 390 minus 239 equal to 151 watt per meter square in loosely defined clear sky. But in a cloudy sky, this formula doesn't work at all. As I have recently reviewed, however, all two-layer climate models are mathematically divergent and hence physically misleading. Hence, any model based on the Arrhenius theory are wrong. Alternatively, one can also use a gray body model for Earth with its atmosphere. If the emissivity is 0.61, as I discussed 4 years ago. In this way, they observed mean planetary radiance, 239 watt per meter square, can be perfectly explained. After that, I had also explained in my talks that the emissivity for such an gray body can also be calculated from the measured planetary albedo, which is a reflectivity of the incoming radiation, namely emissivity equal to 1 minus albedo equal to 0.7, which gives the surface temperature 278 Kelvin without invoking greenhouse effect. Hepper and his former PhD students knew this, but they didn't go further. One reviewer who didn't know this background commented that the albedo I used is a shortwave reflectivity and hence cannot be used to determine the longwave emissivity. I explained to him nothing is wrong with the formula I used because a planetary albedo is just a dimensionless number that is derived from an integral as shown here, where the emissivity inside integral is defined as a spectral emissivity, which is different from the one I used. Then it occurred to me that the 0.3 albedo could be measured with a radiometer with finite frequency window. Then it is likely it could be underestimated because non-wave range such as infrared, far infrared, and microwave might have been excluded in such instrumental measurements. If so, my calculated emissivity could be less than 0.7 or even closer to 0.61, the emissivity that gives the correct surface temperature 288 Kelvin. So we could be all right. I hope future observation of the planetary albedo could confirm this speculation. To help you to compare and understand different models for Earth with its atmosphere, I have prepared this diagram for you. In the first model, Earth with its atmosphere is represented as a blackbody in vacuum, as discussed at the beginning of this talk, whose emissivity is 1 or 100% and its emission temperature is 255 Kelvin. The second and third models describe the Earth with its atmosphere as a gray body. The two emissivities are slightly different at the moment, but they should be identical if and only if the planetary albedo can be measured accurately. Notice none of the three models for Earth with its atmosphere are sensitive to infrared absorbers in the atmosphere, hence no greenhouse effect is required at all. Finally, the fourth model is what has been used or modified by many researchers after 1896, in which the infrared absorber above the surface, as shown by the green ring in this diagram, although its temperature is lower than the surface temperature, 288 Kelvin, would you like to buy an infrared heater whose emission temperature is lower than your room temperature in the winter? Thank you for watching. Thank you for making comments, and thank you for support. See you next time.